In 2000, two young, beautiful Russian girls burst onto the music scene with All the Things She Said. Who are these two Russian girls, you may ask? 15-year-old Liana Katina and Yulia Volkovich, better known as Tattoo. The controversy that surrounds their career worldwide, their image is portrayed as two young, beautiful girls kissing in the rain. This image would stick from their debut in 2000 to their split in 2011. A successful band in the world with records that could not be beat. We will take you back from the start in 2000 to where it all began. On the 4th of October 1984, Liana Katina was born. Her father, Sergei Katina, was a well-known musician in Russia. Her childhood would be dominated by music. By the age of 10, Liana was able to play the piano flawlessly. But by the age of 13, Liana would become a member of a vocal group, an instrumental group, Napsia, or in English, Naughty Children, where she would become friends with Julia. By the age of 15, she had successfully passed through the casting for Project Tattoo. On the 20th of February 1985, Yulia Volkovich was born. Her father wasn't a famous musician, but a very successful businessman in Moscow. Yulia also, by the age of 10, could play the piano. She became a member of Napsia, or Naughty Children, at the age of 9. By the age of 11, Yulia was put into an ordinary school to foster her artistic talent. By the age of 15, she passed the casting to become the final piece of Project Tattoo. As the lesbian image that surrounds their careers, but they didn't start with this lesbian image. The producers, Ivan Salkowski and Alexander Volsky, showed the girls a movie called Show Me Love, released a year before the band existed. The love for a person of the same sex, which led to be an image that is shown in their music video, All the Things She Said. This film would also create the inspiration for the name Tattoo. This was loosely translated from Esto Doshme Lobreti Turo Documento, or This Girl Loves That Girl. Tattoo started writing their debut song in Russian, their first song being Yossi Slasuma, or I Have Lost My Mind. This, the video, would stay at the top of the Russian music charts for 2 months in 2000. With Trevor Horn on board, he wrote All the Things He Said, as well as Not Gonna Get Us. Both would lead back to their Russian versions and the stories back to the duos. We caught an exclusive interview with the girls to find the stories behind Not Gonna Get Us, 30 Minutes, and All the Things She Said. Oh, it's forever, just you
and me. All else is nothing. Not Gonna Get Us. It's about, of course, us. And it's about like really high speed and danger, and that we want to run away from everybody, from our parents, from all the people, from not understanding, and we'll run away. So not gonna get us.
In the middle of our song, All the Things She Said, we sometimes give them. Every time they waiting for this kiss, so they are like crazy, they become crazy, they wow, yes, yes, oh, kiss, kiss, one more time.
Video for this song is like, I'm kissing with a boy
on the carousel,
and Julia is jealous really, and then she did like, you know, boom. Yeah, explosion, and Julia is sitting in the bathroom and doing this bomb.
You know?
I'm kissing with a boy, and
we will kick off our tattoo collection with All the Things She Said.
If I'm asking for help, it's only because
So, Nick, what do you think of the two so at least state of their career?
Well, looking at the history, looks like they have been destined to be singing together. I can see how the two never met. The videos we have seen from the duo have been a bit over the top, but I do think the duo came around at the right time. The video was a hot topic in 2002 because of its content. With the duo kissing, I think some people at the time just could not accept change.
Thank you very much, Nick. Back to you later in the programme. By the year 2000, Tattoo had been recording for several months. Alexander and Ivan had an argument over the direction of the project and where they should go and the look of the duo should go with. As we know, the two have been shown Show Me Love, about same-sex love. Ivan is a big fan of same-sex deep love and wanted the duo to have this that Alexander did not. He likes the links with same-sex, but he's not as extreme as Ivan. As so, Alexander leaves the project to clean his hands of it and keep his reputation clean and intact. Ivan brings in Elena Kipper as his co-producer. He also brings in Trevor Horn and helped with the production of Tattoo's debut album, 200 Kilometers an Hour in the Wrong Lane. I hand over to John and Grace, who did the first UK interview for Tattoo.
Yeah.
I've got to ask you, Lena, you're very keen, it's very rare that we see you without the school uniforms on. Why are you so keen to wear the school uniforms all the time?
I don't know how to answer this question. For example, if you were speaking about our video, first video, all the things you said, Julia said that it was a really super question.
Thank you, Julia.
Спасибо. Because when we were shooting this video, we were in school. And then it was just like an image, just two teenage girls, and Julia said, relax, everything is okay.
Okay. So how old were you when you made the video for all the things you said?
14.
So the kissing scenes between the two of you in the video were when you were both 14 years old?
Yeah.
In 2002, when the duo were only 18, Ivan announced his ridiculous 10-year plan for the girls. This would include interviews around the world on TV, radio, as well as debut world tour. The duo would be living the 24/7 life. This would later come back to haunt Tattoo. Also in 2002, a host of new faces turned up when the producers of Tattoo did some casting around the world to find the unsung musicians that made Tattoo good. Sven Martin, Tattoo's musical director and keyboard player, came from Germany. He's popular himself, pianist Another new face, all the way from Australia, was the guitarist Troy McCabe. He passed through the casting in the UK, but is also popular in over Australia as a guitarist. A man who had the jubilous task of making that classic All the Things He Said drum beat at the beginning was Ruman Arotu from Austria, later then to be replaced by Steve Wilson. They are some of the few drummers who could produce such a sound live. Even though the band had only been around for about 4 years, the duo had been nominated for several awards and won 8 in 4 years and played to millions. Even at the age of 18, the duo were selling out arenas worldwide. They even performed at the tribute to Trevor Horn concert at Wembley in 2003 with All the Things He Said, which would become the start of their image change. Coming third in the 2003 Eurovision competition with Naspi Nople Dosme, or Don't Fear, Don't Believe. This was some achievement, musical project to do this. They were the first music project to finish the competition in third. Here's a clip from the duo featured on Clement Direct when they were asked the hard questions.
Let's get right to the point. Are you lesbians or what?
Everybody ask us, are you lesbians?
Of course,
no.
It's
no, we love each other. We know each other 10 years.
We like just love each other. We're not lesbians. We just love each other.
But how come you had that image before?
We didn't have this image.
Everybody was talking about it. Everybody thought you were lesbians. So and you
we
said
never,
it.
No, we never said it.
You didn't. Everybody thought so, also here in Denmark.
Just everybody thought so.
So you're not?
No. Never was. Never pretend.
You can try.
Oh, I don't think that will be.
We have some students around PharmTech, what they thought of Tattoo. Here they are.
Yeah, Tattoo are very good artists. They are very good singers. They can definitely hit the eye above me.
Bang tidy.
Their second studio album, Dangerous and Moving, was crafted with the help of various popular musical producers. With the help of Sting, Trevor Horn and Richard Carpenter and Brian Adams, the album would be put on hold during 2004, whilst Julia had her baby, Victoria, aged only 19 at the time. The duo would have to put the release of their second album on hold till 2005. This time would help the duo recover from lack of sleep. Due to Ivan pushing the duo, this break would lead to the writing of the book Comeback Tattoo by Aleksey Voskovenko-Morfylenko, and later the film You and I Finding Tattoo, starring the duo. They released The Return in 2005 to the Field of Happiness. They came back with a different look, different attitude to music. They had their own documentary on this return, the Tattoo Experience. Tattoo had won over 55 awards over their entire career and nominated for several others. One of the awards they had won being the most prestigious award going in music, the World Music Award. They had sold millions of records worldwide. In 2009, released their third English studio album, Waste Management. They officially disbanded end of March 2011 and released the release of their film You and I Finding Tattoo. This would cap a phenomenal 12-year career. This set the stage for the duo to go their own ways to solo careers. So Nick, what do you think of their career, so their whole career now?
Well, I think they've had a very progressing career, so it's good that they have literally been quite successful. They've started off small and they've built their way up. And so it's really cool that they've made a film and other stuff to show their success. They've lasted quite a long as musicians, both of them as a duo, until they both split it up. But it was still long for 12 years as they both were together.
Unfortunately, that's the end of our programme here on Echo FM. Hope you enjoyed this week's Blast from the Past, Tattoo. Next week, we'll be featuring about the Beatles. We will end our program with Tattoo, Don't Regret. You don't regret your best embraces.
Was before is no longer here. No more singing songs, silent lips are dry. All that was before slowly passing by. No more saying words, no more crying tears. All that was before is no longer here. No more singing songs just for you and I. Silent nights are long, broken hearts are dry.